Oh, Morricone. I said it right, right?
Yeah, Morricone. Morricone.
All right, I was saying Morricone, I think, man. Sorry, I apologize. But, hey, you guys, disappointing loss tonight. Okay, and you actually came through, had a major decision. Looked pretty tough at 174 pounds. But overall, what was the message Coach Flynn had for you guys after a loss like that?
You know, we have the talent, we have the work ethic, which, you know, we got to bring it. And, I think that's something we do need to work on, and, you know, not just at some weights, but every weight.
Okay, you're 174, 165 pounder. Jared King's able to come back. You guys are both six-year guys, correct?
Yep.
What did that mean to you, and when did you find out?
Well, I got mine a little bit earlier than Jared. I think Jared got his in June, and it's great because he's my best workout partner. So,
would you have wanted to do it if he couldn't have done it?
Yeah, I wanted my year anyway.
You wanted it anyway, yeah, huh?
Him coming back really helped. And we got our coach Kyle Seminara back too. And
okay.
So I work with him a lot too.
Multiple years of injuries in a row is what, you know, qualifies you to get that. What were the injuries that you had that made you eligible for it?
My redshirt freshman year, I dislocated my shoulder, and my senior year, I herniated a disc in my neck.
So you didn't even get to finish your last year. You thought it was it, huh?
Yeah, I thought I was done.
Pretty disappointing.
Yeah, well, I got to wrestle. We had one event, so.
Okay.
It's 3-0.
3-0?
Yeah.
Okay. Right, undefeated, man. I would have quit while I was ahead, yeah, if I were you. But, you know, to be able to come back and have the pride that you guys have, obviously when you watch your Edinburgh guys go out and you fight, you guys are fighting for the name of the school, you know, across your chest. Okay, and you guys are fighting. You look like you're, you know, Coach Flynn, he wants you to fight. But what do you think it means, you know, to be here? A lot of people are like, Edinburgh, you know, where's that? They don't even know anything about it. What's it mean to be a Fighting Scot and to be here? And how does the community treat the wrestling team here?
It's great. I love being a Fighting Scot. You know, the community's real welcoming. You know, we get a lot of the town comes. And it's not just the college students, but, you know, you see people out. And it's real nice. It's a close-knit environment here. And, you know, it's comforting to see your teachers and your
faculty, everybody, yeah, there's administration here, yeah, and everything tonight.
Yeah, everyone comes, it's great. So.
All right, last thing, I'll let you off the hook. I'm looking at your name on the roster, and it says GR behind it. You're getting a graduate degree. What's your graduate degree going to be in?
My graduate degree is in educational leadership.
So you're going to be a teacher?
Administration.
Administration?
Yeah.
You're going to be wearing that tie around?
Yeah.
Oppressing teachers such as me?
I hope so.
All right, Phil, you got anything else for me?
Not.
All right, hey, thanks for the time. And we'll be catching up with you all next weekend. WVU and Pitt, man, I can't wait.
Yeah, I'm excited.